You are listening to the Daily Gospel Reflections with Sister Cloth. This podcast is brought to you by the Paulines Multimedia. It is our mission to bring the Word of God to all peoples through sounds and images, voices and music. Come and join us as we share with you a thought a day. We lift our reading for today from the account of St. John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 18, instead of the gospel proper for today. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came for testimony to bear witness to the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness to the light. The true light that enlightens every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world knew him not. He came to his own home, and his own people received him not. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave a power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Full of grace and truth, we have beheld his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father. John bore witness to him and cried, "This was he of whom I said, He who comes after me ranks before me, for he was before me. And from his fullness have we all received grace upon grace. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only Son, who is in the bosom of the Father. He has made him known." Oh, one day more, and we are bidding goodbye to the happy memories of 2023. We thank God for everything that has happened and for having reached the end of this year in His loving care and protection. We look forward to the new year with the hope that He will continue to direct our lives. We only need to renew our faith in Jesus, who never fails to make His presence felt. In today's reading, St. John assures us when he said, "And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen His glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth." John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace." To further reflect on these words, I would like for us to relish the thoughts of Sister Bernadine Son, author of The Gospel Power, as she elaborates on the Word becoming flesh. That God, who is Spirit, has taken on material form and has become an earthly reality. In Jesus, heaven has come upon earth to remain forever united with us. Therefore, the world will never be the same again as it becomes home to the God in flesh, through whom it exists. Now, what is the implication of this? That every earthly reality deserves respect and care. for nothing is left untouched by the incarnation of the Son of God. Isn't this very inspiring? Realizing that everything breathes of the divine presence. And because God has chosen to become a human being, every human life is incredibly pure and holy in its very essence, because it is now intimately joined to the Word made flesh. With this noble thought, may our contemplation of the mystery of the Incarnation give us new eyes to see and a unique sensitivity to relate with all creation, especially with our fellow brothers and sisters. Lord Jesus, Word in flesh, open our faith vision that we may perceive the sacredness of everything and treat every reality with the reverence it deserves. Amen. Be with us again tomorrow as we share with you a thought a day. Meanwhile, you can follow us and listen to other Apple and Google podcasts on Spotify, produced by Paulines Multimedia. Have a good day.